Hello everyone, today we are going to discuss some important signal operations like folding, shifting and time scaling. So we have discussed folding and shifting in our previous lectures. Now today what I am going to discuss new thing, that is folding with shifting. And today I want to explain what is time scaling, what is called interpolation or upsampling, what is actually downsampling, and if a mixed signal, that is a time shifted signal with time scale signal, is present, how to do them, how to get the result. Okay, so these are the important signal operations and these are the topic of today's discussion. Now, as we know that this is folding and this is shifting operation, and I have nothing to explain that what is folding and what is shifting. You all know now what is delayed signal and what is advanced signal. Now, if I give the signal folded signal with shifting, what will going to happen? So we know that in case of delay, in case of general delay that I have shown in this slide, that the minus sign gives us the delay signal and it is give us the shift in the right hand side. Okay, and this plus signal for a normal operation, it will give us the advanced signal and the shifting is in the left hand side. Now, if I want to move this folded signal, my signal here, my signal was xn minus 3 and xn plus 2. What will happen if it is x of minus n minus 3 or x of minus n plus 2? Today, I am going to discuss that. So this is my original signal xn. This signal, now what I have to do, I am folding this signal. So xn, we know folding means it will create the mirror image. So all the signals in the right hand side of this all the signals of the left hand side of this zero signal will come in the right hand side. So zero here, this is the signal, and this signal of minus 1 at the minus 1 instant is coming to plus 1 instant, and the minus 2th instant is coming to the plus 2th instant. This is all you know. When I will write that I would like to shift this x of minus n, I would like to take the signal as x of minus n minus 2. Now here you will understand it will be the just opposite of the as I have given minus sign, though in normal operation we take minus sign as delay, but here as the n itself is minus, so both of them are having same sign, right? Both of them are having same sign. So it will here will give you the advancement, and the advancement, we know that the advancement will always be in the left hand side. So next, the signal, what will have, this signal will be advanced in the left hand side by 2 unit. So this signal is advanced in the left hand side by 2 units. So 0 is come to minus 2, 1 is at minus 1 and 2 is at 0. Similarly, if this signal is x of, I have to make this signal x of minus n plus 1. Now, as there is a difference between the signal n itself is in the minus, and the constant, the shifting I have to create is having a plus sign here, it will be make the signal delayed. Okay, and as we know, delay will be means right hand side shifting. So here the signal will be shifted by 1 unit in the right hand side. So 0 will be come to 1, 1 will come to 2, and at the signal at 2 will come to at 3. So this is the signal. If it is folded with shifting, it will take just opposite thing. What we consider, that if we consider that when it is delay it will be minus and when it is advance it will be plus, but for the folded signal the thing, the convention is just opposite. Understand? Next is a very important topic, that is called time scaling. Now under time scaling, two types of time scaling we can do. You can understand, scaling means we are going to scale the time sequence. So n is given and we want to get n minus 2. Okay, so how we will proceed for this time scaling? I am writing this signal first. Suppose this signal, I am writing it in a tabular form. So if this is xn, I am giving you the thumb rule how to do this, and then you will understand why this is called upsampling. So suppose xn is, what is xn? We are getting it is 3, 4, 5, 6, 5, 4 and 3. Now what are the values of n? N is 0 under 6. So this will be 1, 2 and 3, and this will be minus 1, minus 2 and minus 3. Now when we are going to get time scaled n by 2, what we have to do? We have to multiply all the elements of n with the value 2. Okay, if it is n by 3, we have to multiply it with 3. So as it is n by 2, we will multiply all the n's with the value 2. Okay, to make it n, what we have to do? We have to multiply it with 2. So we are going to multiply this value of n with 2. So what we are getting after multiplication, we are getting that this 3 is becoming minus 6, minus 4, this is minus 2, 0 plus 2 plus 4 and plus 6. So now what we are getting? We are getting that the signal which was initially at these instances are actually they are going in a distance. They are going apart from each other, and this 3 is actually coming at minus 6. This 4 is coming at n equal to minus 4. This 5 is coming at minus 2, 0, 2, 4, 6. Right? So that means if I draw the signal will be like this. If I write the signal, so the x of n by 2 will be 0. At 0, we are getting 6. So 6, we are getting 0, 6 at 0 instant. Now we are getting 5 at 2. So that means if it is 0, this at 1 there is a 0, and at 2 we are getting 5. Okay. Now at 3 we are getting again a 0. Then we are getting 4 at 4. At 5 we are getting again a 0, and 6 we are getting 3. Similarly, in the left hand side, at minus 2 we are getting 5, but at minus 1 we are getting nothing, so it is 0. So it will be 5. Then again the previous value is 0, and minus 4 we are getting 4. Right? And at minus 5, we are getting nothing. At minus 6, we are getting 3. So, this is basically the signal x of n by 2. And if I draw it, you will understand this will be n. So, at 0, I am getting 6 at 0. Now, after that, at 1, I am getting nothing. Then I am getting 5. At 2. Next, I am getting nothing. Then at 4, I am getting 4. Then at the next point, I am getting nothing. And then I am getting 3. Similarly, here also, at minus 1, I am getting nothing. Whereas at minus 2, I am getting 5. Then at minus 3, I am getting nothing. At minus 4, I am getting 4. Right? Next, at 3, minus 5, I am getting nothing. But at minus 6, I am getting 3. So, that means the signal is actually scattered. Okay, so this is xn by 2. If this is the signal xn, this will be xn by 2. So, you can understand the whole signal is interpolated with so many values of zeros in between. That's why upsampling is also known as interpolation. It is also known as interpolation. Okay, so next we will discuss another type of time scaling, that is just reverse of upsampling, that is downsampling. So you can understand, in upsampling we are getting more number of samples, that is actually it is, that's why it is calling upsampling. Whereas in downsampling, number of samples will less. You can understand from this name. So, it is also known as decimation. Okay. So, what we have to do? Here also, I am writing the signal xn. So, xn, it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now, this 6 is at n equal to 0. So, this will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These are all the sequences. And this is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5. So, you can understand now that if I took twice of n, so, twice of n means to make the coefficient of n equal to 1. What I have to do? I have to divide this n by 2. So, that means I have to divide all the sequences by 2. So, that means what are the sequences coming? It is minus 5 by 2, minus 4 by 2, minus 3 by 2, minus 2 by 2, minus 1 by 2. 0 by 2, 1 by 2, 2 by 2, 3 by 2, 4 by 2, and 5 by 2. Now, among all these values, we have to find which are the whole numbers. Why? Because we all know that n is nothing but sequences. Sequences means 0th sample, first sample, second sample, third sample. So, this n is always be whole number and cannot be a fraction. So, we have to discard which are the fractions. So, this is a fraction. this is a whole number and it is coming, this will be equal to minus 2. This is a fraction, this will be minus 1. This is a fraction, this will be 0. This is also fraction, this is plus 1. This is fraction, this is 2, this is also fraction. So that means we are getting that the sequences are now here, and definitely we will take only the sequences that are present at the whole number. So that means we are going to take the sequences at 2, we are getting this. Okay? So we are going to take this sample. We are going to take this sample, this 4, then we are going to take this 6 present at 0th sequence, then again we are going to take this 4 present at first sequence, then we are going to take the sample, this 1. Okay. So how much downscaled? See, only we are getting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 samples among 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Among so many samples, it has been downscaled. So, what will be our x of 2n? X of 2n will be, so at 0, 6 will be there. Okay. So, at 1, 4 will be there. And at 2, 2 will be there. In left hand side, at minus 1, 4, and at minus 2, we are getting minus 1. Sorry, plus 1. Okay, at minus 2, we are getting plus 1. So, this is the samples. This is the samples present at x of twice n, where xn is this. Okay, so these are the samples. It is not 2, it will, sorry, it is not 1, it will be 2. So 2, 4, 6, 4 and 2. Yes. So in this way, we will able to scale the we will perform the time scaling. Okay, understand? So next, I would like to show you an example with time shifting with scaling. Okay, time shifting with scaling. So here there are two operations. There are two operations. Time shifting is there, as well as time scaling is there. Now, there is a rule of precedence. The rule of precedence say that you shift first and then scale. If it is given, the xn is this, and if it is given in this way, the rule of precedence says that you do time shift first. Time shift first, this will be done first, and next you have to do the scaling. Do the scaling next. Okay. So, if it is given in this way, how you will perform? So, I am showing you that how to do it. First, I will show you the both methods. First, I am showing you if you want to do time shift first and scaling next, then you have to take the signal, the mixed signal as it is, that it is given here just like this. Now, this is your xn. This signal is folded. Okay. Now, this signal is folded. What I will do? I will first fold it. So, what I am going to do here, I will fold it first. So, what I will do? I will fold the signal and make the signal x of minus n. Okay. then I will shift the signal. How to shift? I will shift the whole signal x of minus n with minus 1 in the left hand side, with minus 1, that means I will advance, make it advance as it is folded. Now then what I am going to do? Then I am going to take the scaling operation. I am going to take the scaling operation where I will find this x n by 3 minus 1. Okay, these three things I am going to perform. Okay, so let's start. First, okay, so I am going to take x of minus n. So x of minus n, this is n. So x of minus n, what it will be? 2 will be like this. This is 2. So x of minus n means this will come in this side and these 2 will come in this side. So that means it will be 1, it will be 1, 1, this is 0, and I should have to write this. It will be at 0, then this is at 1, this is at 2 and this is at minus 1. So this is the signal. Okay, now what I am going to do? I will take x of minus n. So that means this is the 0, so this will remain same. These 2 will come in the left hand side, so here 2 will come and 1 will come, right? So these values are minus 1 and minus 2, and at here we will get at plus 1 we will get only 1, right? So this is the inverse signal or folded signal. Next, what I told you, that I am going to, so I have done x of minus n, that I have done. Okay, now what I want to do, I would like to shift the signal. It will be minus n minus 1, this will be minus n minus 1. Okay, so minus n minus 1 means I have to shift this signal in the left hand side. So I have to shift this signal in the left hand side, that means this will come to here, so there will be nothing in the, nothing after 0. So if I want to draw signal minus 1 of my minus n minus 1, how it will look like? This one will come to here, so at 0 I will have 1. This one, this will be at minus 1, this 2 will be at minus 2, and this one will be at minus 3. Okay, so this is the x of minus 1 minus x of minus n minus 1, that I have also done. Next, what I have to do? I have to take the scaling. So what is the scaling? I will take this. Okay, so what I am going to do, I will just as I have scaled the signal, I am showing you the thumb rule. As I have, I have shifted the signal, I will just make the ends. What I have to do, I will multiply all the ends. So now my signal will look like this. My signal will look like this. So if it is 0, the 1 will be at 0. Okay. Now this minus 1 will be multiplied by 3. So it will be at minus 3. So I will get another 1. The next 1 will be at minus 3. In between values will be 0. Next, the signal, next non-zero signal I will find at 6. So 3, 4, 5, 6. What is at 6? 6. At 6 I will get 2. I will get 2 at minus 6. Then non-zero value I will get at minus 9. Minus 7, minus 8, minus 9. So at minus 9 I will get again 1. So now this signal is actually your x of minus n by 3 minus 1. So in this way, if the signals are given in this form, you can understand that here the shifting, you have to go by a whole number. Okay, unless the shifting is the shifted value is a whole number, you cannot take that because they are the sequences. So if the shift, you have to make anyhow, you have to make the shifting part a whole number. So it is a rule where first we have done folding, then we have done shifting, and then we have done the scaling. Now I will show you doing the same signal in a opposite way. Just watch carefully. So now I am going to show you the same operations, but the operations will be in the form. First I will do folding, then I will do the scaling, and then I will do the shifting. But before doing that, I have to do something. I have to make the whole thing scale. That means what I have to write? I should write the signal x of minus n by 3 minus 1 in a whole scale form. That means this whole thing should be scaled. So how to scale it? You have to scale it in this way that you take 3 common from it. So what you are getting? You are getting n minus 3. If it is in this form, then you have to take the scaling first. Okay. So if it is in this form, that, and another thing I would like to tell you, that whatever you do, you have to make the shifting part a whole number, otherwise you cannot shift because it is now sequences. So it was 0, it was 1, it was 2, and it was minus 1. So what I am going to do? First I am going to do the folding operation. So I will take x of minus n. X of minus n means this 0 will be 1. Now this will come in the side, so it will be 2, and then it will be 1. They are at minus 1 and minus 2, and at 1 the value will be only 1. It will be at plus 1. So this is my x of minus n. So I have done the folding. Okay. Now what I have to do? I have to scale it. Okay. So what I have to do? I have to scale the signal. So now, scaling means what I have to do, I have to take the signal in a way that it becomes n by 3. Sorry, I have done a mistake here. If I take the scaling properly, I have to take it as 1 by 3, right? Yes, I have done a mistake. Sorry for that, my mistake. So now that I have to scale this signal, I have to scale this signal by 1 by 3. That means I have to multiply all this. So I am going to scale this signal and I am to make 1 by 3 of minus n. So I am going to taking this scaling operation. So when I am going to take the scaling operation, what is actually happening? I have to multiply and the signal is distributed. This one will be at minus 6. So this one will be at minus 6. Next, this will be at minus 3. So this 2 will be at minus 3. It is at 0. And next, this will be at plus 3. So now this signal is actually x of 1 by 3 of minus n. Now what I have to do? I have to shift it by 3 unit. Okay. So I have to shift it by 3 unit. Where to shift? In the left hand side, because it will be advancement as the signal is already folded, right? So I have to shift it in the left hand side. So in this way, if I shift the signal in the left hand side, it is becoming 3 is coming to 0. So 1 is, this is coming at 0. Next, this 0 is coming at the left hand side. So it will be at minus 3. Then this signal at minus 3 will come to minus 6. It will be at minus 6 and then it will be at minus 9. So the next signal will be at minus 9. So this signal is actually exactly the same. If you remember, this is exactly the same signal we have done with the operation shifting first and the scaling next. Okay. So this signal is actually my minus n by 3 minus 1. This is my signal. Okay. So in this way, what you have to do, that you have to understand which process you will try. But I will suggest you to take the thumb rule of shifting first and scaling next, because it has some advantage. Here I would like to tell you what is the advantage. Look, if you want to scale whole the signal, you cannot do it because this 4 will be 4 by 3 then. Right. But if you take what I have told you first, as there is no folding operation, so if you take the thumb rule or the precedence rule, first the shifting and then the scaling, this will work. So this, take this signal, first shift it. So what to shift, what you have to do, you have to take x of n plus 4. You have to make the signal x of n plus 4. Okay, so here we need the value where the 0th sequence, the 0th sequence is at 2. I missed the arrow. So the 0th sequence is at 2. Okay, so the 0th sequence is at, the 0th sequence is at 6. So this is the signal. So you are going to shift it by 4 units. So here it is also advanced. That means this is 0th sequence. 6 will go 4 units in the left hand side. That means 6 will be at minus 4. Right? So that means this arrow will be in the, it will move, 6 will move in the left hand side. Naturally, the arrow will be go in the right hand side. So if the arrow is at 2, then only it will be minus 1, it will be minus 2, it will be minus 3, and it will be minus 4. So in this way, without drawing, without taking the graphical interpretation, you can also get the sequence. So the new sequence, so 6 is at minus 4, then 5 at minus 3, 4 is at minus 2, 3 is at minus 1, and 2 is at 0. So my arrow comes under 2, right? So this is the shifted signal. Okay, so this is the shifted signal. Now I am going to take the scaling. So what I will do, I am writing the values. I am just writing the values. So x of n plus 4, if I take it in a tabular form, I am getting that 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, where n is here, n is 0, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, and this is plus 1. Now, when you are going to take n, 3n, so you have to divide all the sequences by 3. So it will become minus 4 by 3, it will become 1, it will become 2 by 3, it will become minus 1 by 3, it will 0, it is plus 1 by 3. So what we have to take, we will take only the whole number. So we will take this, this is a whole number, and we will take this is another whole number. So my sequence of x3n plus 4 is becoming, this is the 0th value, so 2 comes under, the arrow comes under 2, and this is at minus 1 comes the 5. So this will be your final answer. I hope you all understood the concept of shifting and scaling, all the important operation on signals. So thank you for your patience hearing.